In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Welcome, everyone, here at Our Lady of Las Vegas Church. Today we gather for the 17th Sunday of Ordinary Time. We are followers of Jesus, and we celebrate our faith on this, the Lord's Day. And so I thank you for being with us as we encounter Christ in this Eucharist today. Let us begin preparing ourselves to meet with Jesus, to come into communion with him, as we first of all acknowledge our sins and as we ask God to grant us mercy and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Adore you.
Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation and nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the second book of Kings. A man came from Baal Shalisha, bringing to Elijah the man of God 20 barley loaves made from the first fruits and fresh grain in the ear. Elisha said, "Give it to the people to eat." But his servant objected, "How can I set this before 100 people?" Elisha insisted, "Give it to the people to eat, for thus says the Lord, they shall eat and there shall be some left over." And when they had eaten, there was some left over, as the Lord had said. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, I, a prisoner for the Lord, urge you to live in a manner worthy of the call you have received, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another through love, striving to preserve the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace, one body and one Spirit, as you were also called to the one hope of your call. One Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is over all and through all and in all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah.
visited his people.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus went across the Sea of Galilee. A large crowd followed him because they saw the signs he was performing on the sick. Jesus went up on the mountain, and there he sat down with his disciples. The Jewish feast of Passover was near. When Jesus raised his eyes and saw a large crowd was coming to him, he said to Philip, "Where can we buy enough food for them to eat?" He said this to test him, because he knew himself what he was going to do. Philip answered him, 200 days' wages worth of food would not be enough for each of them to have a little." One of his disciples, Andrew, the brother of Simon Peter, said to him, "There is a boy here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. But what good are these for so many?" And Jesus said, "Have the people recline." Now there was a great deal of grass in that place, so the men reclined, about 5,000 in number. Then Jesus took the loaves, gave thanks, and distributed them to those who were reclining, and also as much of the fish as they wanted. When they had their fill, he said to his disciples, "Gather the fragments left over so that nothing will be wasted." So they collected them and filled 12 wicker baskets with fragments from the 5 barley loaves that had been more than they could eat. When the people saw the sign that Jesus had done, they said, "This is truly the prophet, the one who is to come into the world." And so since Jesus knew that they were going to come and carry him off to make him king, he withdrew again to the mountain alone. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, during this year, we have been reading from the Gospel of St. Mark, but St. Mark's Gospel is shorter than the others. And so, in order to fill all the Sundays during the year, we are taking a short little break from reading of Mark's Gospel and moving into the Gospel according to St. John, specifically the 6th chapter of his Gospel, which is a very important one and a very interesting one, as it will fold out over the next few weeks, because it is the chapter in which Jesus reveals the Eucharist, a very important topic and a very important thing that Jesus wanted to give us and leave for us. I just want to relay a little story in the beginning of that. There was this little boy, he was in Sunday school, and his mother came to pick him up, and little Johnny said, "Well, boy," he said, "that story of Moses and the Red Sea that we were learning about in class today, that was really something." So the mom says, "Oh, really? Well, tell me about it. What did you hear?" So he goes, "Well, the Israelites got out of Egypt, but Pharaoh and his army chased after them, so the Jews ran as fast as they could until they got to the Red Sea. The Egyptian army was getting closer and closer, so Moses got on his walkie-talkie, and he told the Israeli Air Force to bomb the Egyptians. And while that was happening, the Israeli Navy built a pontoon bridge so that the people could cross over the Red Sea, and they made it." And the mother was like shocked, and he says, "Is that really what they taught you about the Israelites leaving Egypt?" The little boy said, "Well, no, not exactly, but if I told you the way they told it to us, you'd never believe it, Mom." And we know the story about Israelites crossing into the Red Sea as the water divided. But this little boy, the point is this little boy had imbibed a secular mentality into his mind that doesn't make any room for miracles or spiritual realities. And if we're not open to miracles, then we miss the whole point. We miss what's happening. And that's what's happened in the Gospel today. There are people who hear this story of the multiplication of the loaves and fish and say, well, you know what Jesus did? He just prompted the people out there to share what they had in their little bags or baskets or whatever they had. And all these people must have had something, and so everybody got fed. And we go, well, that may be true, and maybe some of the people did feel a little bit more generous when Jesus fed them. But if we read a little bit further into chapter 6, we hear Jesus speaking to them, and we will hear that as we go along, as they find Jesus in another place, and he says, you're not looking for me because you saw signs. It's because you had your fill of the bread. Jesus fed this large group of people with only 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. An amazing story that and happening, really, a miracle that happened in which Jesus fed all those people with just a little amount of food. But in doing so, is showing us that God is sufficient to provide for all his people, that God's gifts and God's grace can never be exhausted, and there is never too much for him. It's always there for us. And Jesus is using this particular miracle as a prelude to what is coming, in which he is going to offer us the Eucharist, in which Jesus is going to give us of himself in a way that's inexhaustible, that there is no way that Jesus could ever be exhausted from all of that. He continues to give, to provide for us, even if it is in that tiny little host that we take, which is his body and blood. We receive Jesus in his fullest, and he continues to do that and does that for us now, even 2,000 years later, after all this happened. And so we have something to look forward to in the coming weeks as this whole teaching of the Eucharist unfolds for us. And it's something very special. And if you want to get ahead, pull out your Bibles and open it up to the Gospel of St. John and read chapter 6, because it has a very special and important message for all of us. So I'd like to conclude with another little story. I don't have really, really good ones, but this one I came across and I thought I'd just share with you. I knew this guy once who said, you know, that he had a dog that could talk. And I said, well, that's impossible. I've never heard of a dog that could talk. I heard of a horse that could talk, Mr. Ed, remember him? But he said, yeah, you ask my dog what's on top of the house, and he'll go, roof, roof. And I said, oh, yeah? Well, I have a bird that can talk too. And you know what he said when his cage fell apart? Cheep, cheep. Sorry. Please rise now, everyone, and join with me as we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth,
of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord as we bring our prayers and our praise before him, as we bring our petitions before the Lord.
For the church, as we share the blessings we've received with those in need, multiplying our generosity through our collective work to house the homeless, support the impoverished, and feed the hungry. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That leaders of every nation may recognize the millions of people in the world who are malnourished and work together to find ways to provide food for those who cannot afford it. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who give themselves to food pantries and soup kitchens, that they may be blessed in their labors, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For trauma doctors and nurses, paramedics and EMTs, and all first responders who care for those whose lives or health are in danger, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who suffer due to extreme summer heat, and for all who provide shelter and assistance to them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have asked for prayers in our community book of prayer, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, may they have eternal rest in the kingdom of heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions of the Godino family, from whom this Mass is offered, and for our own private intentions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. O loving God, you lavish us, your people, with your limitless generosity. We ask you to please respond generously to the prayers that we have made today through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please pray now, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For through his paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere, Father, your mighty works, for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with all the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we now acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and you are the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ's death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. And humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. And remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and George Leo, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Father, welcome them into the light of your face, and have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her beloved spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you, Father, throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and that we may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. For through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Now, at our Savior's command, informed by his divine teaching, together let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, Lord, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
O Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Lord, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, for you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other a sign of peace. Thank you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world, and blessed are those called now to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, everyone, for being with us today and celebrating this Mass on this 17th Sunday of Ordinary Time. Thank you to our ministers, Teresa for lecturing, and from Mikhail for manning the cameras. And as you see, we have a new cantor today, Marlena. Thank you for singing with us, Dave, our beautiful music that always lifts us up in spirit. many people have asked where Eva is, and well, she's doing okay. We know she had her baby back in March, and she's doing okay. She's taking care of all the motherhood things that are going on, but we hope that she'll be back with us soon. And I'd like to thank all of you, too, for all of the support that you've given us. I mean, we've been getting a lot of feedback. I mean, last Sunday, right here in our church here in Our Lady of Las Vegas, there were two separate couples that stopped me and said, Father, we're here from California, and we watch you every Sunday. And we're very happy that that we were here to be celebrate Mass in person, but they continue to watch. So thank you very much for that. And we also just recently got a message from someone in Toledo, Ohio, that where I used to work years ago. But thank you for that feedback and those nice words. We're glad that we can be with you and celebrate the Eucharist with you, at least for the time being. We'll see how long it continues on, but we're very glad to be with you and to celebrate the Eucharist. If anyone is celebrating an anniversary, a birthday, or something good going on in your life, we want to celebrate that with you. Congratulations to you, and God bless you. And also, if you've got more serious issues weighing heavy on your soul, please know that our prayers go with you, and that always know that Jesus is the one that lifts us and brings us consolation and peace. Just trust in him. And so until that next time when we see each other again, let us depart with the Lord's blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is now ended. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God.